advised. If the opinions and views of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
My name is Harry Tambuatco. Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Alam niyo po, bago natin umpisahan itong palatuntunan natin, umpisahan muna natin, ano kaya ang public opinion? Isipin niyo. Alam niyo, nowadays, public opinion is promoted by no less than media. Media tells us what you and I are thinking. What you and I are thinking is second nature. Now, when media tells us what we're thinking, what they do, like a brand, they have to substantiate their brand. So what they do is they go to survey groups. Surveys then identify and strengthen their pronouncements. Whatever they say in media, what they tell us on TV, we are listening, we're watching, this is supported by surveys, meaning to say, oh, di ba? Sabi ko sa iyo eh, ganun na nangyayari. Now, interestingly enough, as of this morning, let's see. The latest survey shows that the top 10 or top 12 contenders or candidates running for the Senate all belong to dynasties. Now, okay, if I'm not mistaken, in the last month, 2 months, 3 months, even four, correct me if I'm wrong, but all you need to do is look at all the broadsheets and on TV, and it tells you even on radio, there's so much talk about political dynasties. And it's not because they're trying to identify it, because we already know what it is. Interestingly enough, Congress still needs to identify it, but this is the makings of the law. What is interesting here is every person I seem to talk to, no matter how high in the social stratum and how low, lahat po tutol sa dinastiya. And yet, the surveys that come out today, 80% of the contenders, the winning contenders in the survey, this latest survey, say all the top contenders are actually political dynasties. Now, what is the truth? This is the interesting part. But is the truth public opinion? In the old days, some 20, 30 years ago, public opinion was taken off the surveys that were supposedly independent. Interestingly enough, it seems to follow what media dictates today. So very much like branding. In branding, because I dabble in branding, and because of super brands. And branding, basically, is the ability to deliver with consistency the brand promise. If you're able to do that, you generate what they call integrity. Kung may integrated ka na, may brand ka na. When you have a brand, you do not generate awareness. It's not necessary unless you're going to do a promotion or a sales promotion of sorts. It is assumed that you have arrived to a certain extent and there is some type of awareness for your brand. But when you promote branding, you don't go towards advertising, you use PR. In other words, you do not let the market dictate or go by itself anywhere else they want to go. You dictate and you control what you call public opinion is to be. How do you do that? By using PR. PR is not like an ad that says, you're number one or I'm the best. This is my product deliverable. PR tells you slowly. It keeps pushing in using media to identify, to promote an idea. Superbrands plays that part when it comes to endorsements. Instead of going to celebrity endorsements, you use award-giving bodies to endorse whatever it is you wish to identify yourself with. Now, let's go back to the real issues. So I've identified PR, or public opinion, and PR being closely related, and survey groups that endorse media is not necessarily the truth. And we can see this today. Unless, of course, there is still a lack of education when it comes to the meaning of political dynasties. Now, pinag-usapan na po natin yan ilang beses na po dito sa programa nito, tsaka sa maraming programa dito po sa GNN. Tsaka nakikita nyo na rin yan, miski sa ANC, at kung saan-saan man, alam nyo, kung manood miski kayo ng mga international TV shows, BBC, CNN, pinag-usapan din yung kasamaan ng political dinastiya. Mga dynasty na nakakamali at nakakabagsak sa ekonomiya ng mga tao sa ilalim ng mga dinastiya. Alam nyo po, kung nag-aaral lang kayo ng history lang ha, sa China, dyan sila bumagsak, dyan sila nagutom. Taon-taon, hundreds of years na lugi sila, nagutom, and they suffered. And today, it's 2012, and close to 80% of the candidates running for positions, and those already in, as of now, the statistics are 70+%. Right now, those who are running will increase this to 80%. That's just in the Senate alone. By the time this election's over, when it goes to the district, which is the local side, of course, Congress, trabaho, nasyonal eh, but they're still elected on the district side, alam niyo po, tataas yan ng 80-90%. Eventually, we will all be ruled by families who are all interrelated. Now, to discuss this very sensitive issue, and the person who's actually put action into his words, who tries hard to stop frustration and makes action, creates action, belonging to the Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption, kilala niyo na po yan, ano? Yan pumunta ng Korte Suprema, si Dante Jimenez po. Dante, thank you very much for being here. Alam mo, I want to congratulate you, first of all, for pushing the writ of mandamus to the Supreme Court, because tama nga naman, ano pang gagawin mo? The writ of mandamus will force the court. Oy, asikasuhin mo yan, because Congress has failed the Constitution. Isn't that the position there?
Yes, Harry. Thank you very much for inviting me.
Nako, I love it when you're in the studio.
Same here. We have a mutual admiration.
Club.
Club. And, you know, ladies and gentlemen, Harry and I have been together for a long, long time. And once he invites me, even less than 24 hours, if I'm here in Manila, I
if in Manila.
Because I want the way he discusses things. It's coming from the heart. That is very important. You know, I'm a lousy speaker. If I read speeches.
Hindi, yeah, magaling ka, ma'am.
No. That's why, okay. Let's go to the question.
Ah, sige. Political dynasties.
Okay. Now that you have explained to our people the impact that it will create among our people, especially our country, I'm pretty sure that so many of us would like to ask, what options can be done so that we can practically eradicate now a political dynasty which is violative of a provision of the Constitution. Matagal na to sinasabi, Article 26.
Section 26.
Article 2, Section
Article
26.
2. I agree.
Okay. That prohibits political dynasty. The problem here is as defined by law. Now, let's go now to the suggestion of one of the retired Chief Justice of the Supreme Court.
Panganiban.
Retired Chief Justice Panganiban. He cited about four things, four options, my dear friends, to finally put a stop on political dynasty. Number one, he said, through legislative or through legislation. Gagawa ro po ang mga Kongreso, House of Representatives, and Senate. Don't you know, Harry, that during the yung kalakasan ng people power in 1987, the former senator, Chufisto Gingon,
yes.
Then a senator, he had the last position as vice president.
Vice president.
Filed a bill.
Sa Senado.
Sa Senado, lusot. 16 na senators ang bumoto. Mali sinasabi ng iba na hindi rin nagpasa na second reading sa bawat chambers. No, ito po 16 bumoto rito. Because at that time there was that height of
nationalism
that we want change. Gingona was able to do it. However, napatay sa House of Representatives. Yun ang naging problema. And every time, up to now, even Congressman, the last Congressman, I know that filed a political dynasty bill in the Senate, is Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago.
Yes.
Sa House of Representatives, si Casino.
Casino.
Bayan muna.
And before that, Satur.
Satur Ocampo, of course, before that. Nawalaan na rin yun. And so, through legislations, sabihin na natin na wala nang pag-asa doon.
Hindi
because
pwede.
Sabi mo nga, this House of Representatives composed of 75%
yes.
members of political family.
And growing. Ah?
And growing. The Senate as well. Hanggang presidente. Umabot na.
So, violative nga ang presidente, ang pamilya ng presidente sa political family.
Precisely. So, sa legislation, sa kikita ko, wala nang pag-asa rito. Even sa susunod na Congress, sa 16th Congress.
Papatay ng Kongreso.
Unless, of course, they vote on Hari.
But, alam mo, Dante, what I don't understand. Your last move, no, yung writ of mandamus mo, challenges the role of Congress in their violation towards the Constitution. You're forcing the court through this writ. Hey, gawin yung trabaho nyo, nakalagay sa Constitution, no, sa Article 2. Diba? Equal access to opportunity for public service and prohibit political dynasties. Those words need no definition. The definition to be defined by law should be the what extent of a dynasty. Ano ba, ikaw muna, ano extent sa iyo ang dynasty? Hanggang saan?
Ay, from top to bottom.
So hanggang,
hanggang barangay.
Okay, so cross-section of any position, but sa mga relatives, so, siyempre, nanay, tatay, mga mag-anak. Okay, father, grandfather, same. First cousin, hindi ka rin tutol ka doon.
Of course.
So, until fourth degree ka.
Sa amin, sa Bicol Autonomy Movement, hanggang fourth degree, we defined it in our charter that we prepared 3 years ago. Yes, so, hanggang fourth degree. But of course, it's still up for Congress to define hanggang saan.
Si Miriam nga, gusto niya hanggang second degree na lang.
Well,
hindi pa rin lumulusot.
Still, nasa sa kanila na yun. Pero etong point ko, why we filed a writ of mandamus against the Congress of the Republic of the Philippines, both houses?
Mm-mm.
Kasi nakita namin dito, the last resort, sabi nga na sa demokrasya, is the Supreme Court. Because the Supreme Court must interpret the law.
Yes.
Yan ang ano po nila, trabaho nila dito. Kaya I disagree with the former Chief Justice Panganiban, nung sinasabi niya na ito raw ano namin, yung aming attempt through judicial process, through the Supreme Court, na filing a writ of mandamus, meaning to say na pipilitin po ang Kongreso, i-define nyo na finally. Because 25 years na, hari. Come on!
Kaya ba? What happened to that writ? What happened to your
application? Nakapending pa ngayon sa Supreme Court. Alam mo naman, ganun kabagal ang Supreme Court, kahit na may bago kang Chief Justice. Ito sasabihin ko, ha? Sabi ni Chief Justice Panganiban, may I read this?
Yes, please.
Sabi niya sa mandamus na final namin, it would be iffy.
Mm-hmm.
Because courts can command the execution only of a purely ministerial act. Hindi niya nabasa yung aming final. We will give him a copy.
Yes.
I-email namin. Because it is mandatory for Congress to define.
Nakasulat lang nga, maliwanag yun.
Maliwanag na. Iniitsipwera lang because of what? Political motives.
Of course.
Not only political but financial. Really, remember, ang politics sa Pilipinas, kasama pera.
Correct.
Andiyan yung mga, alam mo na, ang...
Political dynasties have existed for the last 5 decades but has metastasized to, to exceeding differences only in the last 10 years or 20 years. Because of the party list system, in parliamentary system versus the two-party system na nangyari sa atin, which lost by one vote, nang ibabaw, ang nangyari ngayon, because of term limits, the different congressional seats, nangyari after 9 years or 3 terms, pagdating sa mga local, no, up to congressmen, ang nangyari, ayaw na nila ibigay sa iba, diretso na sa mga anak nila para makabalik uli sila. Rather than magpahinga, hindi ka na makabalik. You know, the reason why the dynasties were born is to make sure equal access to opportunity for public service, which is exactly what is in the Constitution that is prohibited.
Ari, ito nga yung ika-apat. Talagtaw tayo. Kasi babalikan natin yung isang action na gusto ni Chief Ex-Justice Panganiban, which is political action. Ito yung election. Would you believe na ang mga electorate natin, eh ganun po ka, sabihin mong, ayoko naman i-downgrade sila. But you, I'm talking of the masses of our great people who sa ground, sa local, eh talagang may utang na loob na sa mga local
dynasty
officials.
Siyempre, siyempre.
Because kaya nga ito nililigawan ng mga national candidates, ito mga local. Siyempre. Sila kasi nakakabuo nito eh. In Bicol alone.
Oh, grabe kayo. Grabe ang Bicol sa political dynasty.
In Bicol alone. Grabe talaga mag-anuhan dyan. Alam, may sistema sila dyan na paghakot ng mga electorate, ng mga botante, meron pang ano yan, attendance yan. Kasi dyan, eh meron ding payoff dyan. Hindi lang naman ito sa Bicol, but in other parts of the of the country. In ARMM, nakita mo naman
mas malala.
Grabe dun.
Well, the ampatuans alone, there's 72 ampatuans running, considering only 2 years ago, the same ampatuan brand was in distress. And other 72 of them running in this election. Ibang klase, ibang klase. Alam mo, naintindihan kaya ng taong bayan ibig sabihin ng political dynasty? Parang hindi, no?
Mukhang, alam mo, kasi ang iba natin mga politiko and the political family dynasty, they control media in some many parts of the country. Even sa local. Alam mo, ibang mga media, mga politiko dyan, ngayon, nag-activate na sila na naman kanilang radio station because syempre, who approves the permit for telecommunications in the area? Congress!
Congress.
Diba? Sila nagbibigay ng authority niyan. And so, dito sa isang option na sinasabi, how to practically eliminate political dynasty, sa akin, yung election, mahirapan. Because nakatali na nga dyan yung utang na loob at andyan dyan pa yung pera-pera.
So in other words, the people who have been subjugated by political dynasties don't even understand, or better yet, are powerless to do anything against their subjugators. Kumbaga, ganun. Di ba yung political dynasty? May utang na loob ka na dyan, hawa ka na. Yung tatay mo, grandfather mo, lahat sila, utang na loob na sa pamilya na yan. Wala ka na, hindi, wala na. From now on until your children's children, you'll be under this family. Parang ganun.
Totoo yan. And we could cite a lot of examples sa municipalities in some part in many parts of the country. Now let's go to the last option ni ni Chief Justice Pangilinan, which is what people's initiative.
Yeah, people's
sabi
initiative.
Niya
sovereign, yun ang gusto gawin ng ang Kapatiran Party naman.
Sovereign action yan. Okay, din ako dyan. However, you will need a lot a certain percentage.
5%, yeah. 5% of every district.
For every district. Madugo masyado.
Hindi pwede. Parang physically impossible eh.
Yes, and it, talagang grabe. And not only that, it will cost a lot of money sa mga mag-i-initiate nito. You know what I mean? Mm. And so
so all four options binibigay niya, hindi pwede.
Highly improbable. Almost impossible. Now, I will offer one
more option.
Na ito na miss niya. I'm not saying na ito ang the last resort, but it might be the last resort. Ano po ito? There might be a revolution. If people now have been disgruntled with all this political family dynasty in this country, if we, tayo mismo mga intellectuals, tayo yung mga nakakaintindi katulad mo, Hari, at yung mga kababayan natin dito sa Metro Manila, papabayaan lang to because magbibingi-bingihan ba?
Tolerance. That's the virtue that we have to get rid of.
Baka yung ampatuan, yung nangyari sa Maguindanao Massacre,
it will
baka
ma-replicate itself.
Yan
without question.
Remember, political dynasty equates to private armies. Ang mga political family dynasty, imposibleng walang private armies yan. Ito yung lagi ito ng inaano ng Philippine National Police and law enforcers dapat and I was a member of the commission
yes,
ng independent commission against private armies under Chief Justice under former Justice Zinaida Hermosissima? Something like that. The former chief, the former justice.
Okay.
Senarosa. Senarosa Commission. We called it Senarosa Commission.
Against private armies.
Nag-ikot kami sa buong Pilipinas, Hari. You know what? We discovered? Ang tinurn over lang na baril, ito lang po yung mga kakapiranggot at yung mga tira-tira nila doon. Hindi sa amin tinurrender lahat.
Andiyan dyan pa rin yan.
Siyempre, tinago nila yun.
Mga private armies.
Because, take the case of the massacre in Mangiganao. Imagine, ang dami natukso mga regular soldiers and policemen doon sa pangyayaring yun. Natukso because of money. Naano sila, they were enticed to join the group of these accused of masterminding the killing of these people, si including Midgeman.
Yes.
At ilan yan?
57 naman tayo.
58. Yung pinakahuli, yung Momoy yata, Mamoy. Pinakahuli, journalist yun. So, yung mga legitimate nating mga kasundalohan, mga police, natutukso yan. Baka magsa-sideline niya. Sa meager resources that they receive, si simple yan. At they will favor one candidate, I'm pretty sure of that. Mm-mm. So, anong ibig sabihin nito? Pag may private army ang isang political family dynasty sa isang lugar, meron din dito private army, at lahat-lahat sila ay nagkaroon ng... Kasi iba dyan, may mga security agency pa.
Tayo mangyayari dito, tayo magiging collateral damage pag sila nagbakbaka na.
Correct.
At ganun ang mangyayari, oligarkiya.
Correct. And if people will get frustrated, ito yung sinasabi ko, there might be a revolution that will be in the offing. And I hope not. Because wag nating sirain yung tiwala ng tao. Ibig sabihin, imagine nasa poder ka, pagkatapos hindi mo ibibigay yung tamang servisyo at implement itong nasa Bible natin, the Constitution, prohibiting political dynasty. And how can you now provide equal access? Ikaw kung gusto mong tumakbo, kalaban mo isang political dynasty, Hari, come on. Anong magagawa ng isang Hari na tambuhan ko who really has some very good ideas para sa...
I'm going to try, but I am not going to buy the election. I'm non-traditional, Dante, just so you know. And I will not become the monster I wish to replace. That much I guarantee you. We're going to have to take a short break, Dante. Ladies and gentlemen, everything Dante has said, Mr. Jimenez has brought up to us. Tama po lahat to. The proliferation of political dynasties, ang nangyayari po niyan, once they amass critical wealth, they turn into oligarchs. Pag oligarkiya na yan, the private armies come into play because economic power has to be secured. And in this security, the problem is, buti sana kung mayaman na sila, may otoridad na sila, okay na kayo. Ang problema, hindi. Kaya nga naging dynasty because of the word insatiable appetite, greed. Now, habang palaki ng palaki ang pera, mas nangangailangan po yan. Ang nangyayari niyan, insatiable appetite to keep going. What is going to stop these oligarchies from warring against each other? Ang mangyayari po, the people become collateral damage. Pag collateral damage, sila nagbabanggaan. What I don't understand, which I would like to tackle when we do come back, why is it the surveys tell us that close to 70-80% of those running for the Senate, sasabihin sa'yo ng taong bahay, naintindihan ko political dynasty, tutol ako dyan. Tapos sasabihin sa'yo, hindi, pero alam mo, si Cayetano, kailangan, okay yan, maayos na tao yan. Kasi really, maayos siya, ang galing yan eh. Isn't that the same political dynasty we're talking about? Do you understand the meaning of political dynasty? Do you understand the definition? As we come back, we'll tackle that question to understand. We'll talk to Dante, who goes around the provinces a lot, who puts action into words, and who actually puts himself right in front, together with his group, the Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption, but also as an individual. He puts himself in positions of vulnerability, volatility, only to make actions out of the critiques. so that at least malalaman nyo tunay na tao rin siya at yung grupo niyang Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption. When we come back, we're going to add one more title into the topic, the Autonomous Region of Bicol. We'll be right back.